in Broadstairs, house hunting with Amy and Dick, who want to move their two little boys, lock, stock and barrel, to the coast.
Having outgrown their London home, they're looking to buy somewhere close to the beach with a large garden for the boys. So far, for their £500,000 budget, I've shown them two period properties in the centre of town and another near Botany Bay, where they discovered they could get more for their money. The last property on our list is this deceptively spacious four-bedroom chalet bungalow, which I'm confident delivers everything they asked for and more. But it also comes with a higher price tag. At £550,000, it is over budget. However, they did say there was some wiggle room, so I just couldn't resist showing it to them.
For this final property, I've thrown a bit of a wild card into the mix.
Yep.
You've got a bungalow here.
OK. Mm-hmm.
It's not your ordinary type of bungalow.
OK.
It's a super-sized bungalow.
Oh, right, okay.
But just from looking at it on the outside, what are your initial thoughts?
It looks nice. It looks well looked after. Yeah, I like it. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good
you
first
like
impressions.
It?
Yes.
Fantastic. Very good.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I do. I like the look of it. Yes.
Are you ready to go in and see?
Yeah, excited. Yes. Let's go. Yeah.
Come in.
Thank you.
So this bungalow has two bedrooms at the front of the house. You've got one behind this door and one just through here. You've also got a bathroom with a toilet and a separate toilet. Let's look in this first bedroom.
It's a good size, isn't it?
It is a good size.
Yeah.
How do you feel about having a bedroom at the front of your house?
I think that's okay. Is this the master bedroom?
This is one of the bigger bedrooms, but it doesn't have to be your master bedroom.
Okay. Yeah. It's a good vibe, actually, walking in. It feels quite good. Yeah.
I'd like to see more.
Well, are you undecided at the minute?
Yes.
How come?
I was quite taken with that third property.
Right now, Dick, you just need to get that out of your head.
No, I do.
Just get that house out of your head and you just need to be in the moment and just be here,
Right.
So now that that's gone, how are you feeling?
I love it.
Fantastic. Well, you know what? There's more to see. It's just going to get better and better. Follow me. If you're not impressed by this, I don't know what you're going to be impressed by.
It's great. Yeah.
It's massive.
It's massive.
It is. It's huge.
Yeah.
It is huge.
It's a big space.
I mean, how is this for a lounge, kitchen, dining space?
It's good.
Yes?
I'm happy.
It is
and then
gorgeous,
also, just around the corner here, you've got a separate utility space.
See, that's brilliant.
Dick, how are you feeling about it?
I wasn't at all sure about the two front bedrooms, I have to be honest. I'm much more of a traditionalist. We need an upstairs bedroom. However, this is quite a startling space. This
it's
is really,
really
quite nice,
isn't it?
Yeah, it's done very, very well.
Amy, each property that we've been in, you said you want a bigger and bigger garden.
Yes.
So I've saved the best for last.
You have.
Well.
Would you like to go and see it?
Yeah, I
would.
Yes, now.
Your bifolding doors leading out to this amazing entertaining space, really, it could be used for.
Yeah, or a scooter park.
Scooter park, yeah. And then you've got this outdoor area here. I mean, again, this could be your man cave, Dick. It could be an artist studio.
Yeah, true.
It's insulated. It's got electric. Now, there's one more thing at the end of this garden that I want to show you, which I think you'll both like, actually. Come on. Come through here. It's like a little secret garden back here.
It is, isn't it? Yeah.
Dick, you wanted a veg patch. Well, this house comes with a polytunnel.
Fabulous.
Ooh. You could grow endless veggies in here.
Certainly can.
And also, it doesn't encroach on the rest of the garden.
No,
so the boys have got their
separate
space. Right next to the polytunnel is this shed.
Yeah.
This could be your artist studio, perhaps.
It could, yeah.
Honestly, I just think this house offers all of you something pretty special. And you've not even seen all of it yet.
No,
so go and have an explore upstairs. You've got two bedrooms up there as as a bathroom.
Excellent.
And I look forward to seeing what you think later.
Let's go.
Enjoy walking through that massive garden.
Oh, this is nice, isn't it? I like the windows in here.
This would be for one of the boys, wouldn't it?
Probably both boys up here.
Yeah,
so that at night time we wouldn't disturb them downstairs.
That's right.
This is the second bed. Oh, there's a bath.
Oh, that's right, isn't it?
Yeah, with a good sized bath.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's great.
Lovely. It's perfect.
Yeah, another good sized bedroom.
Guys, is this house matching up to your fantasy?
Yes, it is.
I think it
is. We're happy with this one.
It's quite special, yeah.
The garden, I think, is a real selling point, having the space outside. But what did you think of the upstairs as well?
Yeah, we thought that was really
It would be perfect
workable.
Two rooms for the boys.
Yeah.
It is a gorgeous house. Mm-hmm. With that does come a price tag, which is over your budget.
Okay.
It's on the market currently at £550,000.
Okay.
So
it's one to think about.
Yeah.
It's been on the market since May, and the agent has said that reasonable offers will certainly be considered.
Yeah, I'm not surprised that it is at that price.
And the size of the garden and the way that they've done it up.
Well, that's why I wanted to show it you as well, because this is a property that you could move into and do very little structurally, cosmetically. You know, with the other properties, they might be below the budget, but you would have to spend money on making them exactly how you would want them.
That's
true.
I've not thought about that.
No.
So four very different properties, all have something really interesting to offer.
Yep.
But I do think it's time for you guys to have a chat between yourselves, go through them all, and then we'll catch up again and see what you're thinking.
Okay,
all right, good idea.
Shall we head off?
Yes. Yeah, let's go.
Let's do that.
Well, the light's fading on Broadstairs behind us now. Have you enjoyed house hunting along the coast?
We have. It's been great,
No, it's been very interesting indeed,
Well, let's go back to the very first one.
Okay.
Because that first one was really quite in the centre of Broadstairs, 2 minutes walk to the beaches.
Yep.
And that was on for 475, five-bedroom, modern villa.
Yep.
Really lovely decorated throughout, but it had that kind of outside courtyard area rather than a garden.
Which was too small.
It was. It was a fabulous house. But, you know, the courtyard was far too small for
a family.
For us on boys, I think.
With that in mind, we went to the second property, still in Broadstairs, but a bit more of a residential area, a bit quieter, still close to get to the beach.
Yep.
That was on for £499,995, so again, under budget, and it did have a bit more of a garden,
It did.
It was a good-sized garden. I really liked the downstairs of that, but I thought upstairs was...
I think the bathroom was an issue. There was, it wasn't really a big enough bathroom.
So again, would you say that one was discounted, really?
Yes, I think so.
Then we went a bit further out to Kingsgate, really close to Botany Bay. You seem to really like this one, Dick.
I did. I liked the old and the new of it.
You weren't so keen.
I wasn't convinced on that one, to be honest. It didn't flow right for me.
Yeah. The price didn't help with that feeling, between 475 and 500,000, still within your budget.
Maybe. I think it's possible, you know, you really liked it. There's possibilities with it, but I don't think it was the one.
Didn't get to immediately, did it?
No.
Then we had the final property, the supersized bungalow, again in Kingsgate, really close to the beach, near the rugby club. It had a lot going for it. It was over your budget at 550, but in terms of everything that you were looking for, space, garden...
And we could move in immediately.
You could move in immediately and not do anything to it.
Correct.
I really liked it.
Did you get that feeling with that one?
Yeah, I did. I could feel like I could live there and we'd be comfortable there.
I'd be more than happy to live there.
Yeah.
I really would.
It's just it's the price.
You did say there was wiggle room.
I'm not sure
Is it too far over budget or what are your feelings about that?
I think wiggle room depends on what we sell our property for.
It does.
So what do you think the next steps are going to be?
We're going to need to go back to our estate agent and see what we can do with ours. And I wouldn't at all mind chucking something in there.
Chucking something in there? Does that mean like an offer, Dick?
Yes. I wouldn't mind.
Yeah, I think I'd be the
same. Not at all. But I've just got pictures of the boys just sprinting up and down the garden, you know, just really, really enjoying it. Yeah. I thought it would be perfect for them. I really do.